Today, I'm going to share with you from John 13:33 on this Maundy Thursday, the day of Christ's great commandment. He is talking to the disciples and he says, "Little children." Strange thing to call men, isn't it? Little children? Well, that's basically what they were. They were very young boys, ages 12 to the oldest 15. He says, "I shall be with you but a little while longer. You will seek me, as I said to the Jews, though, where I am going, you cannot come. So I say to you now," and here comes the great commandment. You know, if I was going to die tomorrow and I wanted to talk with you one more time, I would sum up what my life was about, what my teachings were about, what this whole mission is about in my last words, wouldn't I? And here he says, "A new commandment I give to you, that you love one another as I have loved you, that you also love one another. By this, all will know that you are my disciples, if you have love for one another." So the great commandment of Christ, if we are really going to follow Jesus, is to follow Jesus at all times, even in the tough times, by showing that we have love for our fellow human being, in words, and more important, in action. Now let me continue. Simon Peter said to him, "Lord, where are you going?" And Jesus answered him, "Where I am going, you cannot follow me now, but you will follow me afterwards." And Peter said to him, "Lord, why can't I follow you now? I will lay down my life for your sake." Jesus said to him, "Will you lay down your life for my sake? Most assuredly, I say to you, the rooster shall not crow until you have denied me three times." So this is something that has meaning for us today. We can follow Jesus and we can follow the way of love until times get tough. And then sometimes in our humanness, we lay it aside and we latch on to anger and lashing out and an eye for an eye and the old ways, the lower ways of living life. No matter what happens, if we are disciples of Christ, we have to follow Him in this way. We have to become God love in expression. And on this Maundy Thursday, I invite you to make a new and a fresh commitment to doing just that. God bless you. Happy Easter.